Quote, scientists were shocked to learn that 90% of the fibers in the primary visceral nerve, the vagus, carry information from the gut to the brain, not the other way around. A big part of our emotions are influenced by nerves in the gut. You know, and that sums it up. You know, and what we're going to talk about today is all that research and the how and the why around why your gut is in charge of your emotions and your mental health rather than the other way around. We have this illusion that we've got this amazing brain. You know, we're different to the animals because we've got this brain. But actually we're not. We're just more slaves than we've ever been. We're slaves to food, we're slaves to cigarettes, we're slaves to drugs, we're slaves to alcohol. And that connection with our gut is the fundamental part that I always start with whenever I'm working with anyone around mental health.
You know,
first step, yeah, look, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a naturopath, I'm not a nutritionist, I'm not a psychologist, so that area of expertise I leave to them. Mm-hmm. Where I can help and where I can offer that holistic advice is around that diet-gut connection. The first thing would be to make sure that they've got a good therapist of some sort or someone they're talking to, you know, so they're getting the help they need in that area. And then getting the blessing from that therapist or the doctor they're working with to go, look, can I work with this patient and help them in the area of the other parts to support mental health? Once we've got that out of the way and then we're away, you know, because all I'm doing is really common sense stuff. It really is really, really basic common sense stuff. So I would always start with the gut and have a conversation with them around what are you eating?